biggest changes for sure, going from orange to purple. And
I would definitely get those too.
Character being Bobby Swift. He did get quite a few speaking lines in Cars 3, whereas Billy Oil Changer in Cars 1 was just a background character. Also a number change. You know, if you want to know why, definitely check out my previous videos on him. But it's just because, for a lot of these, it's because the next gens are voiced by real-life NASCAR drivers, and they wanted the numbers to be the same as their ones in real life, so that means they also had to change the stock car numbers from the first movie. Up next, we got Mood Springs. Chuck Armstrong on the left from Cars 1, and Doug Brolleman on the right from Cars
3. I can still race!
I have to say, I love both of these guys. They are fantastic.
But I would definitely own those too.
I just like the more lively
all of
blue.
Them.
The dark blue is just a little drab. A little too depressing for me. And last but not least for this row here is Gasgrin, Floyd Mulvihill, In-N-Out. One of the most overlooked stock cars, at least in my opinion, from Cars 3. He only was released in a launcher and everyone just kind of forgot about it, it seems. And the design did change quite a bit. You went from those like rounded pills, these spheres, to, you know, more circular oval ones, which is interesting for sure. Hopefully he does get a re-release eventually though, for those who couldn't get him in the launcher. Alright, Ravengo. Now this is the only stock car that does not have a name. I don't know why Mattel did not name this guy. They just called him Ravengo Racer in that Target exclusive 11 pack a year and a half ago. So yeah, he's also a pretty rare stock car. And this is Misty Motorcraft from Cars 1, the only female racer. So it's potentially, you know, possible that this is also a female racer if they want to kind of include that Easter egg. But yeah, the designs are,
you know, decent. Oh, so like Jessica.
Yeah, space on my table here. This is ridiculous. Here we have Leakless now. Another classic. Claude Scruggs on the right from Cars 1 and Brian Spark on the left from Cars 3. Also only available in the launcher. Now, these designs are pretty different in the fact that
definitely one of those two
is much more emphasized on Brian than is on Claude. I still love them both, though. I mean, Leakless is a classic sponsor for sure. Love the white and yellow two-tone. We're just going to put them back there and run out of room. Move on to Gaskets. Don't worry, I didn't forget Apple, but we have Sage Vanderspin on the left from Cars 1 and Rex Rather on the right from Cars 3. Major change is the fact that the blue is quite a bit darker now. They also removed the slogan from the hood and the actual picture of the little cookie, which I'm a little disappointed about. They still do include it on the back corners though. And they do put the slogan on the spoiler. I do wish it was also on the hood. I guess, you know, as times progress, they wanted to make things simpler, and I can understand that. Here we have Vitaline. Also,
yes.
Kind of, I don't know, I wouldn't say a main character, but a supporting character in Cars 3. Brick Yardley, he did have a line. James Cleanair in Cars 1, he was just pretty much a background character. Quite a bit more of a vibrant, brighter green. But still, you know, you got that two-tone going on between green and white. I like the green rims, though. They stand out. Up next, we got Buzine, sticking with our Bs here. Ryan Shields from Cars 1 on the right, and Buck Baringly from Cars 3 on the left. Again, you know, pretty similar.
I want them.
You got the yellow oranges for the number, and then you got a turquoise for the rest. I've been talking about Buzine a lot lately because I reviewed Michael Roeder, then I reviewed the custom Buzine hauler. So yeah, we've been really, you know, loving Buzine lately. Those corrected windshields, man. Yeah, I mean, they even kept the slogans in the exact same positions. This is another, you know, really similar one. And last, before we get to Apple, we have Tocap here, the hitch protector. Again, you know, similar designs for sure. You just have a little bit darker purple, I'd say, or maybe, I don't know if it's darker, but you can definitely tell it's more of a purple than a blue. They did remove the slogan that Tocap originally had, which is probably for the best.
That's gonna be my new collection.
That's pretty much it. We're gonna move on to Apple now, who, as you guys know, Mattel only released the Cars 1 Apple and the Motor Speedway of the South set, that huge, you know, 36 car set, only available to Redline Club members in 2008, and now is probably one of the most sought after items in the cars hobby. So yeah, he's pretty rare, and because of the fact that they made the Apple car so rare for the first movie, they probably won't even release the stock car from Cars 3, and if they do, he'll be extremely rare. Trust me, he'll definitely be one of the most sought-after cars ever. I don't see them doing another, like, Motor Speedway on the South set, though. However, if they were to do it, this would be the year. 2 years after the film release, which is how they did it back for Cars 1. And because of that, we don't know this guy's name from Cars 3, so if you want to come up with a name, please let me know in the comment section below. I'm thinking something, you know, to honor Steve Jobs. I think that'd be pretty cool. But yeah, of course we got, you know, simplistic designs, as it all is for Apple. I love my Apple products without a doubt. Font changed a little bit for the number. Very, very cool. So that is it. Believe it or not, we went through everybody. Everybody. That was a lot of stock cars. That was like almost 80, I believe, individual cars. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you really enjoyed this video. I had a lot of fun doing it. You know, it's kind of nice to take a break from reviews for a little bit and do something that's a little different, a little out of the box, where you can just kind of, I don't know, look at all your cars. Really appreciate them. Because I feel like in today's world, we're always like, you know, trying to get that next new car, and once we get it, we put it on the shelf, and then we worry about the next new car, then the next one. And we don't have much time to really focus on, you know, what we've gotten already. We really gotta appreciate that, so, whoa, that's what I wanted to do with this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I know it was long, but, you know, it's just one of those videos maybe you could listen to in the background while you're getting ready for school.
Definitely want to own these cars.
Watching. But anyways, I will see you guys next time. I got a huge video planned for either next weekend or the weekend after that. Like, it's absolutely insane. Oh my gosh, I'm so excited for it. It's a huge project. I've been working on it. So look forward to that, and I'll see you guys then. Bye now.